Alaska is known globally for its abundance of wild spaces. But alien sightings are equally abundant there as well. Most of these eyewitness events take place in the sky, but there are instances where Alaskans are tormented by a subterranean alien presence. For decades, there have been theories swirling around extraterrestrial creatures living underground, collecting data on the human race. Lake Iliamna is the largest lake in the largest state in the most powerful country in the world. An ideal spot for one of these alien outposts. What does this underground alien want with the people of Lake Iliamna? What information has it been trying to gain? And where is that information going?
I'm Bob Bird. Came to Alaska in 1975. I'm a radio show host. It's 82 degrees in Soldotna. Here at the studio, it's 67.
Bob's show covers a wide range of topics, from politics to health and nutrition. But there's one subject that's consumed him for decades.
I have a documentary crew here in the studio, and you know what we're talking about. They're here to talk about Ili. Yes, the Iliamna monster. I'm wondering what we've got in that lake. We might have something that's unknown to science. The opinions range everywhere, but what it is a mystery. I first heard about the legend of the Lake Iliamna monster from Chuck Krampuschets in the 1960s. He spotted it from the air. He was a missionary, and he also founded a local Christian academy here, and was a member of the Borough Assembly. He's got both feet on the ground. He doesn't make stories up, and he knows what he's looking at. So I don't think you can dismiss Chuck's account at all, but I'm a skeptic. I don't know what to think.
Chuck Krampuschets died in 2004, but his daughter Sarah heard his account many times growing up.
My name is Sarah Erickson, and I live here in Soldotna, Alaska, right on the Kenai River. I am the daughter of Chuck Krampuschets, who saw the big sea monster in Lake Iliamna. My dad was a commercial pilot, a hunting guide. He was also a school teacher, great storyteller. When he told you something, you listened, and you knew, because he wasn't just some fly-by-night guy. I mean, he really had something to say. In the late 1960s, while flying over Lake Iliamna, he saw a giant something in the lake that was so shocking to him that he made some panicked phone calls to people over the radio and said, "There is something enormous in the lake." He could only estimate the length of it from the shadow of his airplane, and he figured it was about 20 feet long. Of course, people were really shocked, but they knew that Dad wouldn't come up with some crazy story. He told it to people all over. I mean, it was just like, yeah, there's something huge that lives down there, and I saw it. Dad, being a realist, you know, an educator, wanted to know what was in that lake. And if it was a fish, then it was a fish. If it was a sturgeon or whatever people thought it was, then it was a sturgeon. He wanted to know. That's who Dad was. It's like, let's see what it is.
Little did Chuck know, the case was about to get even more puzzling.
So he put his float plane in Lake Iliamna, attached a big hook with some caribou meat, threw it out there off the floats, and waited. And suddenly, something huge grabbed that hook and started dragging down his plane. It was pulling him down, pulling the whole airplane, if you can imagine, the floats that want to float, down into the water. Dad had to cut the line because it would have pulled his float plane under the water. That wasn't a snag. He knew there was something giant down there. It scared him to death. So that was something that made him convinced that it is bigger than a fish or a sturgeon or even a whale. There's something huge down there, and he just didn't know what it was. That story has been repeated several times, and not only that, but other pilots have flown over Lake Iliamna, have seen a giant something in there, and that story impacted me in a way where I knew as a very young age, there is more to this world than we will ever understand. There's just some things we can't explain.
Descriptions of how large and seamlessly this strange being moves through the water point to otherworldly origins.
We've had a lot of witnesses since the end of World War II when float planes covered the area. Fishing game people, missionaries, fishing guides. But all those previous sightings were by lone individuals who can be mistaken.
All these years later, Alaskans are still gripped by the mystery of Lake Iliamna.
One morning 3 years ago in the summer, my son called me from Anchorage and said, "Did you see the article in the paper about the Iliamna monster?" And I said, "No." What they saw with 11 different adult witnesses cannot be dismissed. So I picked it up and got some names from the article, and I decided the best thing might be to try and contact these people myself and maybe go on and interview them. I had a friend who was a pilot and had an airplane. I said, "Let's go interview any of the witnesses." That's when I had a good look at the lay of the land and talked to a few of the people who were amongst the 11 witnesses. I checked their stories to see how well they matched, and they were pretty consistent.
Is there any chance that this thing could be from another world, somehow ended up in that lake?
That's outside of my speculation. Something needs explaining there. I don't know what to think. It's a mystery. That's what it is. And there's a mystery that has to be solved.
Bob has continued to look for witnesses, which brought him to two sisters who had an experience all their own.
My name is Christina Salmon. I live in Igiagig, Alaska, and I am the manager for our environmental contracting company.
I'm Alexana Salmon, and I'm the current president of the village council.
Their family are Yupik and have made their home on the banks of Iliamna Lake for generations.
Well, we've lived here our whole lives, and it's a close-knit community, and I think we have a high quality of life out here.
We love our water in Igiagig. You know, we were born and raised drinking it straight out of the lake.
But an otherworldly being stalks residents from the depths of Lake Iliamna.
The stories about the Iliamna Lake monster have been always part of our culture. Our elders have told us from their own accounts of seeing it, and then we can find artifacts thousands of years old that have this creature depicted. And we have an example of it on the mural up at the school.
We were always told that it liked the color red, so people would paint their red boats blue or camo colors because they felt like red attracted the lake monster and they didn't want to be eaten by it.
But the legend never seemed real until the morning of August 6th, 2020.
I was working at my computer and I could see that Christina was up here at the boarding house. My phone was charging, so I thought I'll just run up and talk to her about some pressing issues.
I was parked out in front of our boarding house. It's a cabin that we rent out to fishermen in the summer, and I was picking up my son, and I saw Alexana walking up towards me, and she wanted to talk to me about work, and we were just catching up.
She was in the truck, and she's drinking an iced tea, and I'm facing her, but in the periphery, I can see Lake Iliamna. I'm talking to her, but I could see something happening.
Her eyes are drifting away from me, and we usually converse with eye contact, like polite people do. And so she's looking at me, but she's distracted.
In my mind, I'm thinking, oh, a boat's going under, or what is that? And then it's a boat sinking. Then I thought, oh, beluga whales are up there swimming. And then my mind couldn't register because you can see white. You can see the white beluga in the clear water, and this was sheer black. And then it became unexplainable.